Rocky Jones, Space Ranger.
Space Ranger. Space Ranger.
Starring Richard Crane. In Rocky's Odyssey.
Gracious.
Take a full sweep on the radar, Vex Winkie.
Yes, sir.
There has to be a planetary object if there's an atmosphere.
Without an atmosphere, there can't be thunder and lightning. If the radar Vex doesn't pick up a thing, Rocky, nothing at all.
Professor Newton, is it possible that at one time there were sister moons with a single atmosphere, but who have drifted apart? Could they still be tied together by something we could call an atmosphere chain?
A possibility, Rocky. Yes, a definite possibility.
I get it, and right now we're passing through that atmosphere chain.
That's only a supposition, Winky.
Very good, Bobby. You get an A in mathematics. Now for literature. You are to read this and write a book report.
Oh, sure, Vina. The Odyssey. Hey, Vina, this is poetry. Vina, this book was written thousands of years ago. Well, I know a heap more than this guy, Homer. Why waste my time?
Bobby, you're to read the Odyssey and write me a report.
Ah, Vina, sizzling Saturn.
What's the trouble, Vina?
A slight case of mutiny in the schoolroom.
I've got to read poetry. The Odyssey, an epic poem by Homer. It's enough to make a guy flip his space helmet.
It's a fine book, Bobby.
Sure, for girls, maybe. But what's in it for us men, Rocky? Why, back there, they hadn't much more than invented the wheel.
Granted, Bobby, there have been incredible changes in science and knowledge, but men still have the same desire to explore. You can learn a lot from the Odyssey.
Looks like I jammed my rockets.
That's right, Bobby. You're stuck.
Poetry.
Oh, it isn't poetry the way you mean, Bobby. It's blank verse.
Sizzling Saturn. I'm madder than a hatter.
Rocky, there's an object coming in on radar, Vex.
Chapter one, Bobby. Start reading. Oh, Bobby. You'll meet a man named Ulysses, who's in for plenty of adventure and excitement on his way back to Ithaca.
Rocky. It appears to be a solid mass, approximately 2,000 miles in diameter.
Yes, there appears to be movement. Must be a gypsy moon.
A what, Rocky?
A gypsy moon. It's not anchored in space and therefore not native to any single system. Oh, Winky, have you altered course to approach the object?
Yes, sir, but there's nothing on Visiograph yet. Only the lightning and the thunder.
Are you searching for a sister moon, Rocky? Another gypsy, perhaps?
No, Professor, but the atmosphere chain has to have another terminal. Quick, Winky, focus 10 o'clock on Visiograph.
10 o'clock, sir.
Hey, that isn't a spaceship. It's an airplane.
Goodness gracious.
I get it. That airplane uses this atmosphere chain as a sort of a traffic lane.
Professor Newton, go in with Vina and Bobby.
Vina, Bobby, secure in your blast-off chair.
Strange aircraft ahead.
Ready to return fire, sir.
No, Winky. Orbit jet, the XB-2, to unknown airship. The XB-2 calling unknown airship. Come in. XB-2 to airship. Hold fire.
Trex Amo, Quotanda.
We're on return flight to home planet Earth. We have no desire to conquer or even explore.
Like the thunder and lightning's on their ball team. Here she comes again, Rocky. Shall I return fire?
No, hold fire. Give me an exterior check.
Temperature 100.43 and diminishing. Escape velocity from atmosphere 4.7. Moisture is now... Rocky, she's on our tail and coming fast. Can I return fire?
Exterior check.
Condition exosphere.
Full power.
All she's got, sir.
Look, Winky.
Okay, I get it. Once we passed out of the atmosphere, we slammed the door in their faces.
That's right. They can't fly in outer space.
But why didn't you return fire and destroy the buzzard?
Winky, there's no point in taking advantage of them. They were afraid of us. We probably never saw a spaceship before. Vina, Bobby, Professor Newton, you may come forward.
I wonder what kind of city lies beyond that wall. What kind of people live there?
Not very friendly ones, I'd say.
Better watch it, mister. You're about to crash.
Superstellar. Come on, Rocky. Let's go meet the people.
Yes, Rocky, why don't we?
We're outside the Space Ranger communication band. You know, of course, the report will go to Secretary Drake that we're lost in space.
Oh, so Drake gets another wrinkle. We've given him plenty.
Exploring the Egyptian moons will take months.
But, Rocky, men just have to explore. You said so yourself. Even back in the time of the Odyssey, you were making me read.
Rocky, we must act now. There's no telling where those gypsy moons may go. We may never find them again.
All right, you've convinced me. I'll try to send a message which conveys friendship before attempting a landing. This is Rocky Jones in the XV-2.
Handcuffs! Quattro Mamator! Mano! Mamator Maximo!
This is Rocky Jones in the orbit jet, licensed in the Space Ranger Service as the XV-2.
Rex Frau von Vexator.
Von Vexator Vexator.
I know you can't understand my words, but I hope my voice carries friendship.
Von Vexator Vexator.
We're preparing to land and hope for a friendly meeting when we translate each other's language. Secure, Professor. We are unarmed. There's nothing to fear.
Von Vexator Vexator.
The vowel.
Alert, learn this. Alert, learn this. Prepare for landing, secure. Terrain unknown. Winky, give me a 90 degree error signal in the gyro.
Error signal in, sir. Skipper, there's a strong starboard tail pull. It's like we're being magnetized.
Full power on starboard rockets, Winky.
Full starboard rockets, sir. We can't fight that pull. It's counteracting full port side, sir. It's not my doing.
Give me an altitude countdown.
65,000, sir. 60,000. 55,000. 50,000. 45,000. 40,000. 35,000. 30,000. 25,000. 20,000.
No use, Winky. When a pinwheel drop and can't pull out. Save the rockets, Winky.
Thank you.
Rocky? Did we get sucked into a tornado?
Must be the people on that moon. There's an electromagnet pulling on our starboard tail section, and another on the port side.
Can't we do anything?
Against that power, Winky, we're just a toy.
Fixed up, Avalo. Fixed up.
Rex, I'm over Vexator.
Well, the merry-go-round's over. Who grabbed the brass ring?
I'd say all of us, Winky. Alert and learn this. Learn this. We have landed successfully. You may unsecure and come forward.
Hey, Rocky, that was a cinch, huh?
Oh, yes, Bobby, a cinch.
Well, goodness gracious.
Hey, Vina, they're nice-looking people.
They attempted to kill us. No telling what they'll do now. Winky.
Sir?
Open the tail section hatch and keep out of sight. They don't know what they expect to find, but curiosity will bring them forward.
Aye, aye, sir.
Professor Newton, Bobby, keep out of sight in the second section. Vina.
Yes, Rocky?
Take your phone to the translator. They'll probably speak when they see you, so get a tune in on their language as soon as possible.
All right, Rocky.
And Vina, don't worry. If they make a move, we'll be able to handle them.
Quotanda, Publex Tavexito.
Tavexito Publex. Bavaro, Tavexito Bavaro.
Winky, come forward. All clear for the moment. Professor Newton, Bobby. Bobby, Professor, meet the people.
Bavaro, Quantimo Tafaro.
Von Vexitos, Quotanda. Obina. A great many of their words start with quo, and there's a free usage of consonants.
Say something more, Rocky. I need correction on exchange language balance.
You can't understand us now, but this machine will translate our languages and write the words for you to read.
A perfect tuning, I believe, Rocky.
If you please. You'd better come with me, Vina.
Well, that's it all.
All set, Rocky. We're locked in translanguage.
Thank you, Vina. May I introduce myself? Rocky Jones, commander of the spaceship in the service of the Space Rangers with headquarters on the planet Earth.
Quindante, Quintampo.
The man in there is amazed. He just said, goodness gracious, exactly like Professor Newton.
Speak into this, please.
Volvan Bovaro. Quintumovex.
This is the man speaking. His name is Bavaro. His wife, Quotanda. They're the rulers of this moon called Posita.
Bavaro, what is the name of the other moon which links Posita with the atmosphere chain?
It is called Nagato.
Electric
electricity even governs their language. The names Posida and Negato must come from the opposite electrical poles, positive and negative.
Doesn't sound like they get along very well together.
Well, may I introduce my crew? The young lady with me is Vina. And in your compartment, Professor Newton, Bobby, and Winky.
Professor Newton? Dopey? Winky?
Well, that's close enough.
Quintando Vortex. Quintanda.
Rocky, he's offering us friendship and rewards. Great secrets about electricity. Anything we want.
Yes, Vina. But in return, he wants us to blast Negato. He has a bomb which, if dropped, would leave Negato in ruins. But so far, their defending airships have made that impossible. He knows that we can stand off in space, out of reach, and do the job.
Rocky, he talks like a madman. Destroy Negato. Destroy Negato, he keeps saying. Quintanda's talking now. She wants me to be her friend. She's inviting me to go to her castle.
Better not chance leaving the spaceship.
Vivaro demands an answer. We have no alternative, he says. We must obey his command. Quintanda's our only chance. Let me go with her and become friends.
Quintanda, will you come in here, please? Vina shall be your guest. And Bavaro, will you remain in there so that you can answer my questions about the war between Posida and Negato?
Vina?
That's right, Quintanda. Quacky bon. No, Quintanda. Rocky Jones.
I don't know about letting Vina go in there, Professor. I sure hope it works out all right.
By your own words, Bavaro, you are the aggressor in the war with Negato. No, Bavaro, there isn't a threat you can make that will change my mind. Well, he's not going to murder us, at least not right now. But he orders us to abandon the spaceship and travel on foot to the far side of the moon. We'll have to exist as best we can. He's sure that in time it will force us to change our minds.
And Vina?
She'll be kept prisoner in the castle until we do change our minds. Until we agree to destroy Negato for them. He says he has a way to control Vina's mind so that she will soon despise us unless we do what he asks. Get through that wall, we might have a chance to rescue Vina. Winky.
Sir?
Fire missiles, concentrated direction. See if we can cut through that wall.
Aye, aye, sir.
Ready, Winky?
Standing by, sir.
Fire one. Fire two. Fire three.
Really? Shall we try a full salvo, sir?
Save missiles, Winky. Won't do any good.
Oh, Rocky.
Yes, Bobby.
You know that book you started me reading? The Odyssey? Well, this man, this Ulysses you told me about, is on his way back home to Ithaca after the war with Troy. And in that war, Rocky, they were up against a wall, just as big as that. So, they built a wooden horse, big enough for the soldiers to get in, and pretended they were defeated and left it. So, these Trojans got itching with curiosity. That horse sitting out there all alone, and hauled it in. And just like that, Rocky, the soldiers got in, and the Trojans were defeated.
And we use the spaceship as a Trojan horse. Is that what you're thinking, Bobby?
I'm not thinking anything in particular, Rocky. I'm just telling you what I read.
Yes, it might work. Now, we'll all leave from the tail section hatch, as if agreeing to Bavar's ultimatum to abandon the spaceship. They'll think we're going to live in exile on the other side of the moon. Now, Bavaro doesn't know about the escape hatch on the starboard side of the ship, so, Winky, you and I will sneak back in and hope that human nature hasn't changed.
Right.
Bobby, the orbit jet will be the Trojan horse, and Bavaro will open the gates and pull us into the city. Professor Newton, you and Bobby stay hidden in the jungle. If Winky and I win the fight and rescue Vina, we'll find you.
One quick time. One quick time.
So good, but Bobby forgot to tell us how they won the fight once they were inside the walls.
I'm afraid I can't help on that point either, Winky. We better take positions. They'll be entering the ship any moment.
I know that Cotanda will do everything possible to influence Bavaro to let us leave.
Yes, but Rocky, even if Bavaro does allow us to blast off from this moon, are the instruments so polarized by magnetism that they won't work?
I don't know, Professor, but we'll soon find out.
Hey, Winky, don't lose my place.
I just want to read the finish of the book. I want to find out if this guy Ulysses and his crew ever got back home.
same time, same station, when we again take you into outer space for further adventures with Rocky Jones, Space Rangers.